It just took 2 minutes, thanks to a beautiful goal by Luke Shaw, for the England fans to dream about a major title since the 1966 World Cup. But the dream and the theme of its coming home changed to its going to Rome in just a few hours because of two tactical blunders by English coach Gareth Southgate. What are the two blunders? The first one, ironically, was a plan which had brought them success all throughout the tournament. That is to score a goal and defend that lead, not go too much on the attack, keep possession of the ball and defend very, very strongly. Keep the defense tight. But against this Italy side, they couldn't keep control of the ball. They couldn't keep control of the midfield. After that first 20-25 odd minutes, it was all Italy. Italy was all over England. England couldn't press forward. Harry Kane was totally off. Apart from a few Raheem Sterling runs, the aged defenders Chiellini and Bonucci both were not troubled that much, and the Italy defense was not under that pressure. England just took one shot on target in the whole match, and that was the goal scored by Luke Shaw. On the other hand, Italy took 6 shots on target, and when Verratti and Jorginho took control of the midfield, and on the other hand, the runs by Chiesa, shots on target by Chiesa, Insigne, all these attacks were building up. It was very easy to predict that at one point of time the English defense will fall apart. And to give credit to English goalkeeper Jordan Pickford, he kept the Italians away with a few good saves for a long period of time. But when from a goal mouth melee Bonucci scored, it seemed that Italy had taken control of the match. And England still didn't wake up. Gareth Southgate introduced Saka, one of the most attacking players, who had brilliant combos with Harry Kane and Raheem Sterling down the right hand side, the right wing, and was a brilliant part of England's attack, was introduced so late in the match. Jack Grealish, the person who always creates for England, is a brilliant player for Aston Villa, wasn't introduced, I think, until the 100th minute of the game. So what was the coach waiting and thinking for? I think Southgate's plan was to keep this 1-0 lead, and even if it's 1-1, let's try and go to the penalties. And there he committed the next big blunder. When it was 120th minute, he brought on two youngsters, Jadon Sancho and Marcus Rashford, both very talented, but maybe they are good penalty takers when it comes to the practice sessions which England had. He brought on to take penalties, he substituted somebody like Jordan Henderson, and that was a big mistake because these players hardly got touches on the ball, hardly got warmed up to take those penalties. When it's practice session, remember, these players practice for 1 or 2 hours, and then take those penalty shots in practice. In the match situation, they hardly had any time to warm up. They were brought on and directly they were facing this sea of English crowd, experienced Italy team, and a mountain of a goalkeeper in Gianluigi Donnarumma. That was so difficult because you had players like Grealish and Raheem Sterling on the pitch, and they could have also been asked to take penalties, but they were not. Three youngsters who missed the penalties were Rashford, who tried his a lot of trick and then hit the post. Gianluigi Donnarumma stood his ground and didn't show his move, and finally Rashford hit the post, and on the other hand, Saka and Jadon Sancho's penalty were saved by Donnarumma. That was a big mistake because that made it so easy for Italy. Even Italy missed two penalties, and again Jordan Pickford, with his height, is not that great, but he kept them in the penalty shootout too, just like he had kept them in the game in the normal time. But this wrong choice of penalty takers, who might be great players, who might be enough talented, but you need, logic says that you need to warm up, you need a few touches, you need that feel of the ball before taking the penalties, and the penalties were very weak. they were not aimed at a particular corner of the net. And when Gianluigi Donnarumma, with so much height, guesses it right and jumps to a side where the ball is hit, be 95% assured that he will save the shot, because his reach is so much that it is impossible for himself to not save the shot. So that was a big blunder by Gareth Southgate, and England's penalty curse, the penalty trauma, continues in major trophies. It's been numerous times that England have lost out on penalties, and this was one another occasion. So that's how it came to an end for England. On the other hand, Italy created a lot of history by winning this title. If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel, and for now I'll take your leave. Bye bye.